Howdy, swim fans. Here is another episode of Whiteboard Wednesday. Today, we're talking about the workout and set structure. Swimming can be a super powerful form of exercise, but to get the most out of it, you need to understand how a workout is actually created. And the structure of the workout will allow you to create the most efficient and powerful workouts. To start, we look at the set. Now, a set is a specific way that you'll do a certain number of repetitions over a certain distance with a certain stroke type with a specified amount of rest. Now, a set, which we have an example here, which we'll talk about in a little bit, is broken up into each component, and multiple sets will create a set group. A set group is essentially a collection of multiple sets. Now, each set has repetitions for a total distance of a certain stroke type on a certain interval. Now, interval training is a really important concept to understand because it'll allow you to get the most efficient aerobic training in. The interval is composed of your total swim time plus your rest time, and this is something that's often misunderstood. You can do an interval based on the total number of breaths you take, or it can be only rest, but the most standard form of competitive swim training is where the interval is your swim time plus your rest time. So if we look at the example set that we have right now, 4 times 100 freestyle at 2 minutes. 4 represents the number of repetitions. So for whatever distance is defined, which is 100 in this case, you're going to do 4 of those. And the stroke type that you're swimming is freestyle. So you do 100 yards or meters freestyle 4 times. The interval of 2 minutes represents the swim time plus the rest time. So if you can swim 100 freestyle in 1 minute and 30 seconds, you'll have 30 seconds of rest before you have to leave for number 2, and you'll do 4 of those total. So 4 100s freestyle on the 2 minute will take 8 minutes total, even if it only takes you 1 minute and 30 seconds to actually swim the 100. So in that scenario, your swim time will be 6 minutes over the course of the entire set, but the total set will take 8 minutes because the interval is what dictates how long the actual set will be. Now, the next step of understanding how a workout and how a set is structured is the flow of a workout. Every single workout will have a few major components, and these differ based on the point in the season that you're at, as well as the actual type of workout that you're doing. For example, most workouts will have a warm-up set group. That'll be followed by either a drill set or a preset, which typically gets you ready to do the main set. And after the main set, you may or may not do a post-main set followed by a cool down. So there's a lot of different components that can define a workout, but not all of these will be present in every single workout that you do. Let's take a look at this workout that I have written up here. As you can see the flow of the workout, there's a warm-up, a drill set, a main set, followed by a cool-down set. If we look at the warm-up, starting out with a 1 200 freestyle at the 4 minutes. Now you might be thinking to yourself, what's the point of an interval if you're only doing one repetition? The idea is after you do 1 200 at the 4 minutes, you would start the next set in the set group that is the warm-up. After the 200 freestyle, you'll do 450s kick on the 120. If you notice, each of the different stroke types have their own abbreviation. So FR is short for freestyle, K is short for kick, the drill is drill, and in this case, we have a dedicated drill set where it looks like we're doing 425s of a particular drill, maybe it's the fist drill, followed by another set of 425s drill. Let's call it 3 strokes plus 12 kicks. And the idea is to focus on a specific component of the stroke on the drill set, so that way when you get into the main set, you can apply whatever you were working on in the drill set onto the main set. If you look at the intervals here on the main set, 4 100s freestyle on the 2 minute, followed by 475s freestyle on the 130, 450s on the minute, and then 425s on the 30. Now it looks like the goal of this set is aerobic focus in nature because the interval stays on the same pace relative to the total distance of the swim. For example, 425s on the 32nd, it means that for every 25 yards, it takes 30 seconds. If we double that to 50, it'll take a minute. 1:30, 2 minutes. So that's what I believe the goal of this main set to be. Now, after the main set, we're doing a cool down, 450s freestyle on the minute. Now, this total workout is 1,800 meters. It's very easy to see sets like this where either the main set or the drill set or even the warm up will have a repeat around the set group. In other words, instead of doing this main set once, you can even do it two rounds. So you might see something that looks like this, a bracket around the main set, and that way you do it multiple times. So your volume would go from 1,800 meters, and you would add another 9,000 meters to the workout. So instead of 1,800 meters, this workout now becomes 2,800 meters. And if you were to do this for three rounds, then this would become a 3,800 meter workout. As you can see, there's a lot of manipulation that can be done to the actual workout structure that leaves the fundamental components in place, but can drastically change the overall impact of the workout. So you might be thinking to yourself, what is this mystery set that we have here? So if you made it this far in the video, thanks for watching. Time to unveil what we have in our mystery set. So the first part represents the total number of reps. Instead, I'm gonna unveil the second part, which represents the distance. Now, if you notice, I left out the stroke count because for this set, we're gonna assume freestyle. So if we remove this set right here, it looks like we're doing 100, so that's the distance. Now the question is, how many 100s are we going to do? If we relieve door one, 100 times 100 at the minute. So this would take 100 minutes and it would be 10,000 meters. So this is called Old School Monday. Most people can't swim 100 in a minute, but it's always cool to see some ridiculous set like that. So I hope this video got to show you a little bit about what it means to have set structure and workout structure and how some of the elements of swimming fit together to create the most optimal workout for you. Until next time, have fun and happy swimming.